We'll start first.
Do you think Saturday was the first time where you were made uncomfortable in the pocket and it was a bit of a challenge? Do you think that will help you in the long run, having gone through that experience?
Almost definitely, yes.
Why so?
Just, you know, having a different type of atmosphere, having a different type of, you know, plays than you usually do. You know, only my fifth game in, but definitely helped out with my experience.
And you think there's no way you'll ever play in a more hostile environment than this one?
Probably not the rest of the season, but definitely a really tough place to play.
Dwayne, what goes through your mind when you see some of the quotes or bulletin board material that you saw on game day? You made reference to it. You obviously saw it. What went through your mind after taking notice of it?
I definitely was upset, but, you know, it is what it is. You got to take it with a grain of salt. Can't let it get the best of you. So, I mean, I seen it, but I got over it.
Do you seek that kind of stuff out? Do you use it for motivation? Do you like having that kind of chip on your shoulder or wanting to prove somebody wrong?
I feel like I would naturally just have a chip on my shoulder, just being myself. It definitely helped out a lot just because, you know, knowing people on that team, playing with some players on that team that I went to high school with, so I added some extra motivation for that game.
Did you get to say anything afterwards?
Nope. I mean, I seen Don Holland after the game. He didn't play. He spoke a little bit after the game.
Your wide receiving core, they're so veteran. I can't remember a time in Ohio State had 3 fifth-year seniors that were integral in the wide receiving core.
Yep.
I know you're used to it, but do you ever think about, man, this is such a veteran wide receiving core?
Yeah, I most definitely have guys like, you know, Paris, Johnny, and Terry played before big-time games, been here for a long time, helps out with my experience, and, you know, having KJ and Allison and Ben all played in big-time games before, it makes it easier for me to collect a lot.
What's the best block you saw one of them throw in the last couple of weeks? What's the best block that stands out?
There's so many blocks, honestly, I can't even tell you which one's my favorite. But I definitely carry with that scoring block for KJ.
Yeah.
It meant a lot for our team for that game. So those guys made a lot of plays blocking as well as catching.
Are you amazed the zeal that they approach that with, blocking? I mean,
No. Wide
receivers are usually these guys that want to look pretty. And, you know, I mean,
yeah.
that's the prototype, so to speak.
Yeah, that's the – for them, it's not about them. They're the most toughest receivers I've ever been around before. And it's all about the group more than the person.
Hey, Dwayne, did you see the play that Johnny made on your interception, or on the interception play?
Yeah.
Running down. What was your vantage point? Did you see it as it was happening, or on film? Or
I watched it on film. You know, Johnny's really fast, so it wasn't surprising.
When I ask you what the sideline was like Saturday, what's the first thing that comes to mind? Like, what's the first story you can tell me that tells me what that sideline was like when you guys were down?
We never wavered, not one time. You know, of course, we were down a couple times throughout the game, but we all stayed with a positive mindset. We relied on our defense when we needed them to make the plays when we needed them, and we were up people all the time.
Was there some guy that said something that stood out to you, or some guy who, you know, just a moment of resolve that stood out to you?
I feel like probably it wasn't any, like, moment of resolve or, like, a key moment. I felt like this, you know, being the leader of the offense, I got to continuously just be on my guys, making sure that they're keeping their head up. You know, can't get down on ourselves if we don't make a play when we need to make a play. But just whether it was me or Isaiah or Johnny or whoever was talking, you know, when we all talk, we all listen to each other. So a lot of respect there.
Dwayne, how did you develop throughout the game? Did you get better as it went?
Most definitely, that's how I got better. But it wasn't about me getting better, about the offense, figuring out what they were doing, figuring out how we're going to attack them. Didn't give us much, and we didn't realize that at first. Kept on trying to figure out what we could do to what we were able to do. So we figured it out as we went on.
When you watched the video of it, what are the one or two things that you were able to dissect and realize, okay, this is what I have to learn from that game, I have to get better at this or that?
I wouldn't say there was anything that, like, I didn't know I already could get better at. I can get better at everything. I feel like I'm not perfect at all. And you know, there's only some of the games I got to play so far. So just seeing some plays where I can reset my feet a little better, or like pick up protection a little better, or be louder in some occasions of the game. You know, just little things all add up as you watch the game that you see. But I feel like I learned a lot from that game.
When you watch Indiana on video defensively, what stands out about them?
Well, coach, you know, really talented group. You know, played a lot of ball together. We had a tough time with him last year, first game of the season. So we're getting some stuff ready for him.
When you say well coached as a quarterback, you mean they're in the right place at the right where they're supposed to be? I mean, explain what that means in your vernacular.
Well, what I mean well coached is that what they do scheme wise as far as defense, that they do it well, and that there isn't stuff that they don't do that they don't know how to do. So whatever covers you run, they're in the right place. You know, whether it's a nuance and that we've never seen before. You know, every team we played so far has had a pretty solid defensive coordinator, pretty solid defense, and whatever they do defensively, they're really good at.
Who have you played before this year that's come out exactly the way you thought they would? Anybody?
I think everybody came out as pretty strong. You know,
no, but I meant,
how
lined
accurate
up.
Is the scouting
video been? Penn State seemed to throw some things at y'all. It looked like.
I mean, I expect a lot of pressure.
Yeah.
Versus Penn State, but I seen 32 fire and Sam Rifle come in and all that stuff, but we didn't have the right plays dialed up for the situation, so I'm keeping better at that.
Dwayne, given what happened last year, against Penn State and then the end of the Iowa game, what's practice been like in preparation for Indiana to possibly avoid another repeat of that season?
Definitely, just college football, every game matters, and we gotta win every game, so not gonna take Indiana for granted at all. I'm going to come out and play with hard and push.
Has it been like a normal practice, questions. Or has it been maybe a little bit more, tougher, just in comparison to, how you've done every practice this week?
I feel like every practice is like a championship practice. Every practice is an opportunity to play against one of the better teams in the country, whoever you play. So, the atmosphere, the demeanor doesn't change much. Every game matters, I feel like.
When you looked at film, specifically on the pass to Ben, just can you take us through what you see when you look at that in terms of your ability to step up in the pocket and avoid pressure on that and how that kind of thing specifically will help you going forward?
Well, if it wasn't loud, I play with him, when it happened. So I seen Sam Rifle and smoke to the field, and we didn't have enough time to change the play. So I couldn't, the play was designed for Johnny to run a deep post down the field, and he blitzed on us. So I just sat back in the pocket. I seen the blitz unfold before the play happened, couldn't change the play. So I got the snap and just got some depth just to let the pressure come up the field so the car could pick me up. I just slid into the pocket, some drills I did before in summer, and found Ben, made a hell of a play, and that's how that kind of play unfolded.
Did you take more depth in that drop on purpose? Because you could tell on that was maybe the deepest drop of the night for you.
Yeah, it was a play action pass, bootleg type of play. I wouldn't have got that much depth on it if it wasn't a pressure, but I seen the pressure coming, so I was trying to buy myself some time.
Is it amazing
last
to you
right
that, because you retweeted, I think, the video that somebody showed of you with Deshaun Watson, over the summer, where he ran through that same exact scenario. Was that even flashing through your head as you did it? You understand what I'm saying? Having done it before.
I wouldn't say that exact rep or play flashed in my head, but it's just
step
muscle
up.
Memory.
Yeah.
Having reps like that in practice, I always tell Coach Jay I want to do something drills that are realistic for the game. And that play, that drill was realistic for me in that game. So just being able to have that in my bank before, to be able to use it in that moment is key for me.